Henrik Sedin gets the puck on the right wing behind the net for Daniel. Into the right wing corner for Henrik again. Henrik, right wing hash marks, leaves in the corner for Daniel. Daniel curls towards the high slot. Wrist one in front. Henrik tipped it. Then he was pulled down. And no call. Hansen down the right wing. Centering pass. Daniel missed it. Puck comes back to Bieksa at the left point. He slams it in deep for Henrik Sedin. Henrik centers. That was blocked. Daniel gets the puck. Feeds it back. Kevin Bieksa fakes the shot. Bieksa wrists one in front. That deflects to the far corner. Burrows hustles after the puck. Works it free to Edler. Now knocked down by high stick. Deflects back to Bieksa. He shoots. He scores! Kevin Bieksa! 10-18 into overtime. The double overtime goal. And the Canucks, for the third time in their history, will play for the Stanley Cup.
The slap shot from Bieksa. Stuff the Sharks! Hang that on the wall! And the Canucks are going to the Stanley Cup Final!
There's ticker tape littering everything here at Rogers Arena. It's a sea of blue, green, and white. Antti Niemi never saw it coming. He was distracted, looking behind him, and Bieksa bounced one in, glove side, to send the Canucks to the Stanley Cup Final.
One of the strangest overtime goals you're going to see. The puck was running around from behind the net, went off the glass, bounced to the top of the blue line, where Bieksa takes a swipe at it. Bouncing, rolling, and by Niemi. He didn't even see it. And the Canucks celebrate.
So do the fans here at Rogers Arena, and so does an entire province. That, by hockey definition, was a muffin from 60 feet out. The Sharks were appealing for a whistle. Niemi was leading the appeal, and Bieksa caught him unawares to win the hockey game. And now they're lined up at center to shake hands as the Canucks get it done. A late goal by Kessler forcing overtime. And a berth in the Stanley Cup Final awaits.
This puck almost made it out of the zone. But Edler was able to keep it in. He shoveled it down. It went off a Shark stick. Took just a strange left turn off the glass. And a goal scorer from Grimsby does it again.
I see some hats at the Vancouver bench already. I'm guessing there's been a Western Conference champion hat drawn up as the players who didn't play in this hockey game are gathered at the bench waiting to greet their exhausted teammates who are on cloud nine. And now the players on the ice are donning hats as well. There's going to be a trophy presentation tonight. The Clarence S. Campbell Bowl is in Rogers Arena. And it's now coming down the tunnel, I believe. Yes, it is. And the fans are chanting about another cup. They don't want a bowl, Dave. They want a cup. And the Canucks are going to have a chance to play for it.
They want all the silverware. But you got to go one step at a time. And they'll enjoy this.
Rick Ball's waiting in the Vancouver bench. Such bedlam in here. There's so many wireless signals. We'll hope that he's able to join us with some guests as the Canucks continue to celebrate. The handshakes are done. Now they've set out a table at center ice with the NHL logo emblazoned, and that's where they'll place the trophy emblematic of Western Conference supremacy. The Canucks won the regular season portion of the West. Now they've won it where it matters most. And hey, you can vote now for the Toyota BC Dealers Player of the Game at teamradio.ca. Get up to $4,000 cash back on select Toyotas, but hurry. Red tag days end soon. It's blue, green, and silver ticker days here in Vancouver. An entire province is celebrating this. Mike Gillis is at the Vancouver bench. He's all smiles. It's quite a throng at the Vancouver bench. Rick Ball's in the middle of that. I see Alex Edler making his way over. And I think he's going to join Rick Ball right now. as Alex Edler makes his way to the Vancouver bench. We'll send things to Rick Ball after the Canucks win it in double overtime.
All right, thanks, guys. Alex Edler, how does it feel?
It's hard to describe. It's great. It was a long, tough game. But, I don't know, we got it done, and it's a great feeling right now.
Talk about the play, first of all, of Roberto, especially in the first half of the game. They had chances to take a lead, and he was spectacular on that 5-on-3. Just your thoughts on your goaltender tonight.
Yeah, I mean, he's brought his A game tonight, he's making some huge saves. They got a lot of the outshots, but he's making big saves, and that's what we need.
I just can't imagine what it's like in a situation like you're in right now. Just the third time in the history of the franchise, Alex, the Canucks are going to the Stanley Cup Final. What's going through your mind?
Yeah, something really special. I mean, and it's great to be in this city with these fans. It's a great feeling.
Alex, I'll let you get back there and celebrate with the boys. Thank you very much, and good luck in the final.
Thank you.
Here you go, guys. Alex Edler.
The trophy, thanks, Rick, has made its way out. Bill Daly, Deputy Commissioner of the NHL.
To the captain of your Vancouver Canucks, Henrik Sedin.
Henrik with a clap of the hands to salute the fans. And he'll move over to the Clarence S. Campbell Bowl and have his picture taken next to it along with Bill Daly. And that might be about all Henrik Sedin does. I'm not sure he's going to reenact the Trevor Linden lid drop of 94.
That's been done. Leave it in the archives.
And Henrik, with a pump of the fists, heads back to rejoin his teammates. And a big hug for him as they continue to mob each other. We talked about this on the pregame show, Dave. The beauty of this, wrapping it up in five, you know you've got a little time to feel good, a little time to celebrate. There isn't a game one in 48 hours, and the Canucks are going to do that right now.
Nothing like being able to watch one of the two opponents you're going to face as the Bruins and the Lightning will get at it tomorrow.
And we're going to have a victory lap now as the Canucks in unison skate around what was the San Jose end of the ice in double overtime, where Kevin Bieksa bounced one in. They're not booing, they're looing for the three-star selections as Roberto Luongo, along with his teammates, salutes this sellout crowd, which gets a chance to come back. We knew they'd be back anyway. The worst the Canucks could do in this series was play a game seven here. But they're going to do better than that when they open up a best of seven. They know they've got home ice advantage. It'll start here. We don't know when. But it'll be against either the Boston Bruins or the Tampa Bay Lightning.
And the Canucks, there was the game five answer as they failed to put away opponents twice in game fives. First Chicago, then Nashville. And this OT goes their way. And think about the guy that put it in the net. And go back to the summer. And Sammy Salo, the injury, the season. Edler, back surgery, Salo in. Bieksa stays. And his shot puts the Canucks into the finals.
You know, you said it was a weird one like we've never seen. But it wasn't that different from the Scott Niedermayer overtime goal in 2007, which eliminated the Canucks in Game 5 with Roberto Luongo distracted and appealing to an official for a penalty. In this case, I think the Sharks thought the puck had gone out of play and back onto the ice surface. But the Canucks get the winner. Henrik Sedin, another big night. And as he makes his way along the bench, Rick Ball is waiting for him. One last handshake for the trainers. And Henrik Sedin is with Rick Ball.
All right, thank you, guys. Henrik, obviously a highlight of your career in the NHL. What's going through your head right now?
It's tough to put in words. I mean, it's the battles we've been through, the ups and downs, and to be here now in the Stanley Cup Finals, that's, I don't know, it's tough to talk about.
Let's talk a bit about the series for you. I mean, Nashville did a good job. You guys didn't produce, in terms of points, as a line as much as you want to, I'm sure, but what a bounce-back series against San Jose. At one point, you had assists on six straight goals prior to the overtime winner. What's the difference, do you think, against San Jose?
I don't know. It's a lot of small things. I mean, our line has really clicked coming together here. I mean, we're working hard for each other, putting pucks in the areas where we want to put them, and we're making plays. I think we're in the Nashville series, I think we overdid some things. We instead of making the pass that we can make, we tried to get pucks to the net, and a lot of times they kept us to the outside. So,
Henrik, you're just the third man in history to captain the Canucks to a Stanley Cup final. How does that feel?
unbelievable with the guys that's been before me. It's a great honor to be with these guys, and Trevor was a big part of our career here, and to be after him, it's a great feeling.
Talked all year about being in the moment, one game at a time. You're going to take at least a little bit of time and celebrate this one before you get set for the next round?
Yeah, until we know who we're playing, we're going to celebrate.
Thanks, Henrik. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
There you go, guys. The captain, Henrik Sedin, and what a series he had. As I mentioned, six straight assists prior to the overtime winner, and I think he'd been on a 9 of the previous 12 goals, and that line was spectacular tonight.
He did in this series, Rick, what Ryan Kesler did against Nashville. He just seemed to be in on everything. But was Kesler ever in on a big one tonight, assisted by Henrik Sedin as he forced the overtime? And Bieksa ended it at 10-18 of the double overtime. The fourth longest game in Canucks history.